Daniel from Twin Bytes here with another tutorial for you. This time I'm going to show you how to change the spacing of the icons on your Windows 10 desktop. You might have it like this by default, but maybe you want to make them wider like this or tighten them right up like this. I'm going to show you exactly how to do that in this video coming right up. So the first thing you want to do is go into your registry editor. So through the start menu, just type in regedit and you'll find it. Now the first thing you should always do is right click at the top level and go to export and take a backup of your registry and make sure you're exporting everything. If something goes sideways, you can always go back into file and import the changes or import your backup before any of the changes were made. Once you have a backup in place, what you want to do is go under HKEY current user and then look under the control panel. Then we're going to go under desktop and then finally the Windows metrics. On the right side of the screen, you're going to have a whole bunch of different options that you can play around with. And assuming you have that backup in place, then you shouldn't have to worry about anything. So you'll see there's two options here. There's an icon spacing and there's icon vertical spacing. One of them, as this names, it changes the spacing vertically while the other changes it horizontally. Although it's not exactly labeled correctly in my opinion, the vertical spacing changes the spacing between the rows, which in my opinion is kind of horizontal, where the icon spacing, which by default here would say horizontal, I would assume, but it changes the spacing between the columns. So then the icon spacing makes everything tight more to the left, where the vertical spacing will shift everything up. So let's have a look at this one here. You can see as an example that the icons are all facing down further to the taskbar. So we'll just go like this so it goes all the way down. So I'm going to go into the vertical spacing, double click on that. It shows minus 1125, which is the default. Now what we want to do is tighten this right up, which we'll put in minus 480, which is the smallest we can go. We'll hit OK on that. Close out of here. And we'll have to log out of Windows and back in before we can see the changes. Can see here that it's tightened up the icons where they're actually overlapping each other here now. It's also for some reason decided to move the icons and put them into additional columns now on me when I just had two columns. Now it's moved it into four, so I'm not sure why it did that, but it did. So we can see that the column spacing hasn't changed, they're still spread out that far. So let's go back into the registry and change that. So that was the icon vertical spacing. Let's look at the icon spacing. Double click, put in the minus 480 to make it the smallest possible. And again, we'll log out and log back in again. You can see that it's tightened this up as well. Let's have a look at the opposite side of this scale. So the 480 is the smallest, and according to Microsoft, the default is minus 1125. We want to go into 2730 for the largest amount of space. And let's do that on both. Now that we have that for icon spacing and vertical, again, we'll sign out and sign back in again. Now, not only are they spaced horizontally, but also vertically, depending on the terminology, whether you use Microsoft's terminology or mine, the horizontal or the vertical. So you can change them that easily in the registry. And if you found this video helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.